on board and 10 crew members, totaling 69 people. The flight was at 37,000 feet altitude and disappeared before entering Egyptian airspace 80 miles, which is 10 minutes. The tweet read, Egyptian Air has informed all relevant authorities and search and rescue teams are being deployed. That's according to that tweet. Please respond to that. I want to bring in Peter Goles, an aviation analyst, CNN aviation analyst. Having read that, tell us what you come up with here, Peter.
Well, I think I'm in general agreement with Mary. When something happens at 37,000 feet and you disappear from radar, it generally is not a very good outcome. There are obviously cases in the past where planes have faced catastrophic events. But again, this could be weather, it could be pilot error, it could be terrorism. And I think you start with terrorism after looking at the weather. But I think we're looking at a pretty grave situation tonight.
Mm-hmm. So we're going to check weather. We'll talk about weather in just a moment. But why do you say terrorism is number two up that high?
Well, I mean, we live in a world in which the terrorists continue to focus on aviation as a tool to try and get their message out. We saw it at Sharm el-Sheikh. There is continuing political unrest in Egypt, and it would not surprise me if this traces back to something like terrorism.
Mm-hmm. When you talk about Sharm el-Sheikh, you talk about the Metrojet plane that went down back in November, and it was categorically saying that it was not an accident, again, that it was terrorism.
A bomb was placed on board.
Right, right. So terrorism would be number two. You said weather, terrorism.
Well, it could be weather. It could be it could be pilot error.
Right, and then you would look at it
sort.
It's
more difficult than most people imagine to fly a plane at 37,000 feet.
Mm-hmm.
You can get into trouble awfully quickly.
Mm-hmm.
But if there's been no indications of radio calls of distress, simply that the plane disappeared from radar. And that's pretty ominous.
Do we still have correspondent Ian Lee with us? Ian Lee is in Cairo and is getting information and waiting word from there. So as soon as we can get Ian and he has some information, we'll bring him back. I want to get to CNN's David Soucy now. David, I want to get your assessment on the